Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you know that we are discussing your the syllabus of next revision test, that is 3.6. So in the last video we discussed the chapter Madam Rides the Bus and questions which have been asked in various years board examination question papers from that chapter. So today dear students, we are going to discuss the questions. First we will be going through the summary of a triumph of surgery, and then we will discuss extra questions which have been asked in various years examination question papers. Okay, so let us begin. And dear students, you must go through all the chapters once again before watching the video, and you must rewrite all the questions, answers to all the questions which are being discussed in the videos as well as in online classes. So let me show you note on your screen through which we will be going through the summary of the lesson. Then I will show you some important questions on the screen and questions which are asked in various years board examinations question paper. So let me show you the notes on your screen. Chapter 1 in your Footprints Without Feet. A Triumph of Surgery, written by James Herriot. The story recounts the episode where the narrator, a veterinary surgeon, saves the life of a dog, Tricky, by hospitalizing him to prevent him from being overfed by his wealthy owner, Mrs. Pomfrey, who was simply worsening his condition. Summary of the chapter. Dr. Herriot had pulled up his car when he saw Mrs. Pomfrey with her little dog on the street. The dog was very fat. He had blood red and rheumy eyes. His tongue lolled from his jaws. Dr. Herriot was shocked to see his appearance. Mrs. Pomfrey called Tricky, the little dog, as listless. He had no energy, so she gave him extras between meals, but his health could not be built up. Even the malt, curd liver oil and a bowl of Horlicks failed to make him sleepy. Mrs. Pomfrey cut down on the sweet things but relented when Tricky started getting weaker. She gave him his favorite cream and cakes and chocolates. She gave him food at odd and irregular hours. She gave him only little walks and no other exercise. The doctor advised Mrs. Pomfrey to cut Tricky's food right down to give him more exercise. Mrs. Pomfrey cut down on the sweet things but relented when Tricky started getting weaker. She gave him his favorite cream cakes and chocolates. She gave him food and odd and irregular hours. She gave him food at odd and irregular hours. She gave him only little walks and no other exercise. The doctor advised Mrs. Pomfrey to cut Ricky's food right down and to give him more exercise. Mrs. Pomfrey got determined to adhere to the doctor's stern advice. Dr. Herriot watched Tricky's progress but was not satisfied. Soon after, he left eating and kept vomiting and panting. The doctor suggested that Tricky should be kept under observation in the hospital. Mrs. Pomfrey started wailing when Dr. Herriot took Tricky to his hospital. Everybody in her household, including her maids, were in tears. Tricky could not even wag his tail or kick with his legs. His eyes too had become dull and he lay down motionless on the carpet. The other dogs at the surgery ignored him as an uninteresting object. The doctor gave him plenty of water. He became a bit energetic after 2 days. On the third day, he trotted out and enjoyed the company of other dogs. He also started eating properly. The doctor did not give Tricky any medicinal treatment. All day he frolicked with other dogs cheerfully. He got out of danger and started convalescing rapidly. Mrs. Pomfrey inquired about Tricky on phone many times a day. She gave suffering from the pangs of his separation. Ultimately, she was told that Tricky had recovered. She reached the surgery by car and collected him. The doctor brought Tricky in his arms. Tricky jumped into Mrs. Pomfrey's lap and started licking her face. Tears were shining in her eyes. She thanked the doctor with trembling lips. Now, let me show you some important questions which have been asked in board examination. Footprints without feet, chapter 1, a triumph of surgery, examination type questions. Question number 1. This episode describes the silly behavior of a rich woman who is foolishly indulgent, perhaps because she is lonely. Do you think such people are merely silly, or can their action cause harm to others? Mrs. Pomfrey is worried and distraught because Tricky would not eat anything. He even is not ready to eat his favorite dishes. Tricky has bouts of vomiting and spends all his time laying on the rug and panting. Tricky does not even want to go for walks or do anything. Question number 2. What kind of a person do you think the narrator or veterinary surgeon is? Would you say he is tactful as well as full of common sense? So these sorts of people have enough disposable money but are ignorant about results of their actions. They show their excessive love and affection without knowing its consequences to others. Undoubtedly, their intentions are good but don't have any sorts of ill will. These actions do more harm than good to the object of affection. Here, in this note, one thing, dear students, we can find that the question is about veterinary surgeon, but the answer is given about, Mrs. Pomfrey. So, how we should write answer to this question? We should write, yes. What kind of person do you think the narrator or veterinary surgeon is? So veterinary surgeon is very clever, is a very wise man, and he was very responsible towards his duty. So when he saw the dog and he asked Mrs. Pomfrey to cut his food, so would you say he is tactful as well as full of common sense? Yes, of course. The veterinary surgeon is tactful because he already had planned to admit the Tricky, okay, and full of common sense. So, the way he had planned to admit the Tricky in the hospital in the search for surgery, as Tricky did not need any surgery, he only cut down his food and he got well. So these things proves that he is tactful as well as full of common sense. Why does Mrs. Pomfrey think the dog's recovery is a triumph of surgery? So I think the narrator, a veterinary surgeon, seems to be this answer which is given, the third one, it should be the answer of the second one. Okay, so why does Mrs. Pomfrey think the dog's recovery is a triumph of surgery? Because Mrs. Pomfrey was not aware that the dog got no treatment. Mrs. Pomfrey was not aware that the dog got no treatment. Dr. Heriot, the veterinary surgeon, he only put him on a strict diet and his condition improved. So considering it was the miracle of surgery, Mrs. Pomfrey called it a triumph of surgery. Okay, let us discuss more questions. Extract based questions. And did you cut down on his sweet things as I told you? Now questions. What sweet things are being referred in the extract? So the sweet things mentioned in the extract are cream cakes and chocolates. Why does the speaker inquire if the sweet things have been cut down? So the speaker inquires if the sweet things have been cut down because these were spoiling Tricky's health and he needed to be put on a strict diet. What is the meaning of the phrase cut down? So the phrase cut down means to reduce the quantity of something. What is the opposite of sweet? So sour is the opposite of sweet. Question number 2 has also been asked in CBSE examination 2014. I tried to sound severe. Now, I really mean this. If you don't cut his food right down and give him more exercise, he is going to be really ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a strict diet. So now questions. Why did the speaker try to sound severe? So the speaker tried to sound severe to make Mrs. Pumphrey take his advice seriously and act on it. Question B. For whom was the advice given and why? So the advice was given for Tricky because he had become obese and listless. He was unwell and speaker wanted him to be on a strict diet. So find the word in the extract which is a synonym of serious. So the word severe. What is the synonym of hardened? That is softened. Question number 3. As I moved off, Mrs. Pumphrey, with a despairing cry, threw an armful of the little coats through the window. I looked in the mirror before I turned the corner of the drive. Everybody was in tears. Where was the speaker? No questions. Where was the speaker going and with whom? So the speaker was going to the hospital with Tricky. Why was everybody in tears? So everybody was in tears that Tricky was being hospitalized and he was ill. Everyone was worried about his health. Find the word in the extract which is an antonym of the word cheerful. So the word depressing. What is the opposite of before? So that is after. Question number 4 has also been asked in CBSE examination 2012. Poor old lad, I said, you haven't a kick in you, but I think I know a cure for you. So why does the speaker say poor and old? So the speaker addresses Tricky as a poor and old because he is unwell and listless. B. What cure did the speaker know? So the speaker knew that the cure of Tricky's illness is to put him on a strict diet. What is the meaning of a kick in extract? So the phrase means any alertness. What is synonym of cure? So heal is a synonym of cure. Now short answer type questions, 2 marks each. Question number 1 has also been asked in CBSE examination. What made James Herriot expect a call from Mrs. Pumphrey? So James Herriot's encounter with Mrs. Pumphrey and Tricky made him expect a call for help. He was sure that the extra diet and no physical activity would soon put Ricky's health in danger. And just as anticipated, Mrs. Pumphrey called the vet a few days afterwards. Question number 2. What extra did Mrs. Pumphrey start to give Tricky and why? Mrs. Pumphrey thought that Tricky was suffering from malnutrition as he was weak and listless. So he started to give him extra snacks like cod liver oil and malt between the main meal and Horlicks after dinner and to make him stronger. She also continued his cream cakes and chocolate. Question number 3. What made Mrs. Pumphrey call the vet?
So Tricky's condition made Mrs. Pumphrey call the vet for help. Tricky had become fat and lazy. He just used to lie on his rug and pant. He also refused to eat food, even his favorite dishes. His bouts of vomiting added to Mrs. Pumphrey's worry. That is why she called James Herriot. Question number 4. How can you say that it was hard for Mrs. Pumphrey to part with her doting pet? So Mrs. Pumphrey treated Tricky as her own child. She loved him very much. It was difficult for her to see Tricky in such a situation. She was distraught when she had to make the decision to hospitalize Tricky. For her love for him knew no bounds. It was a terrible and tearful moment for her, but she agreed to Herriot's suggestion for the betterment of the pet.
Now, question number 5. What kind of treatment was given to Tricky? Did it help in his recovery? So, Tricky was given a non-medicinal treatment. His diet regimen was altered depending upon his body's response to it. His diet was reduced. He was kept on liquid diet for the first 2 days and then his diet was gradually increased. So yes, this treatment did help Tricky or helped Tricky as it built up energy in him and he had transformed to an energetic, hard-muscled dog in just a fortnight. Question number 6. Was Tricky suffering from any ailment in reality? If not, then what made him inactive and lethargic? So, Tricky was not suffering from any ailment. It was his greed for food and the love of his mistress that spoiled his health to such an extent he was being overfed every day, and that made him obese and lethargic. So that is why his health showed a rapid improvement when his diet was controlled. Question number 7. Briefly describe Heriot's days of content. So the time of Tricky's stay at the hospital was a period of content of Heriot to enjoy the treat that arrived in the name of Tricky. So as he could not afford all this for himself, so Heriot used to relish and fresh eggs in breakfast, wine before and during lunch, and brandy in the night. Do you think Tricky was enjoying his stay at the hospital? It has also been asked in CBSC examination 2011. So yes, Tricky was definitely enjoying his stay at the hospital. He had befriended the gang of shabby household dogs. He had found a new joy in being bowled over, trampled on and squashed. He had also become very energetic. He used to play and run all day long with the dogs. He was having a great time. Now, value-based questions, long answer type, value-based questions. Excess of everything is bad. Comment in the wake of Mrs. Pomfrey's love for Tricky. So Mrs. Pomfrey was a rich woman who loved her dog very much. She loved to live a comfortable and lavish life and also wanted her dog to spend a similar one. She had maintained the wardrobe full of fancy fur coats, dresses, beds, etc. for Tricky. Apart from this, she used to overfeed Tricky out of her love and concern. She used to serve him cod liver oil and malt given the main meals, and Horlicks after dinner to give him strength. She never realized that Tricky was a greedy dog and this would spoil his health. She could not even refuse to answer Tricky, refusing for cream cakes and chocolates. Her overfeeding worsened Tricky's condition. This made the dog lazy, inactive and obese. He used to lie on his rug and pant all the day. Mrs. Pomfrey fed him excessively, spoiling Tricky's health to such an extent that he had to be hospitalized. Even in the hospital, she continued to convey Tricky her love through eggs, wine and brandy. Her fondness and care for Tricky proved that excess of everything made him fall sick. Now, question number 2 has also been asked in CBSC examination 2015. Pen down incidences in support of values one should inculcate from Mrs. James Heriot. So Mr. James Heriot was a capable veterinary surgeon who treated Tricky. He was a very compassionate doctor and a wise and sympathetic human being. He showed his capabilities almost immediately when he advised Mrs. Pumphrey to put Tricky on a strict diet. After understanding his symptoms, he can also be said to be an understanding and tactful person, as he knew exactly how to free Tricky from the spoiling love of Mrs. Pumphrey for his treatment. He does not operate upon the poor dog unnecessarily and adopts a practical approach to treat him. Mr. James was a caring and polite individual, as he successfully allays Mrs. Pumphrey's anxiety about Tricky's recovery patiently. He was in all a good human being and a successful professional. Question number 3 has also been asked in CBSC examination 2012. Do you think parents like Mrs. Pumphrey exist? If yes, it is good thing to pamper children. Why or why not? Yes, parents like Mrs. Pumphrey definitely exist. These people spoil their children by taking sure all their demands, completing all their demands are met. They spoil their children in the name of love and care. They not only feed them junk but also spoil their social habits. This kind of behavior is very harmful for children. Such overprotective parental behavior hinders their growth as adults. In fact, it shows the seeds of greed and dependency in them. They became stillborn and do not learn to value anything. For them, hard work is a myth, as they get everything easily. Over-pampered children often fail to face the hardships of life later. As for them, life has been a cakewalk. Pampering children in moderation is healthy, but excess of it is harmful. It is not just bad for humans but also for animals, as we see in the story of Triumph of Surgery. So it's all about this lesson, dear students. You can practice more questions from internet or different sample papers, and the answers which we have discussed here, they are just model answers. You should rewrite all the answers after going through the chapters once again. So thank you for watching. See you tomorrow with a new topic.